Hello everyone, this is Patrick Masson. I'm the General Manager at the Open Source Initiative. And today we are kicking off, or maybe it's more of the beginning of our promotional cycle, of a new initiative we're starting called OSIdeas. The OSIdeas came out of a discussion with the Advocate Circle and a few of the members there to provide a forum to discuss interests and issues specific to open source licenses, issues around the Open Source Initiative, how we operate, the things we do, and of course, software freedom. And most importantly, how those things affect the development of open source software and the projects and communities. So I'd like to start off with some really introductions on backgrounds and interests. So Casey, can you please share a little bit about your open source background and your interest in working with the OSI's Advocate Circle and the OSIdeas project?
Happy to. Thanks, Patrick. So my open source experience was gained primarily at IBM, related to open source diligence and product clearance. My interest in working with the OSI's Advocate Circle is related to exploring more or less standards, hopefully around notices files, and also related to how a non-lawyer and non-engineer can engage in open source.
Great. Thanks so much. Traven Keith is also going to be working with us on OSIdeas. Traven, can you give us a little background about yourself?
Sure, yeah. So right now I'm doing mostly around consulting for things around technical solutions development, as well as business strategy, and also a lot of things around marketing, which is where my main academic background's in. But with open source, it's a way for me to get more technical experience. Actually, I've been around the space since around 2005, although much more now than I was before. And, you know, it's a great way for me to learn because so many people are just willing to share ideas, provide education to me. So, you know, I'd like to say I'm self-taught, but really it was just because of the community helping me out. So this is a way for me to give back, and I'm excited to be part of this.
Great, thanks. Casey, I was wondering if I could follow up a bit. You know, licensing and IP is such an exciting topic within the open source community. Could you share a little bit more about the work you're doing, the notices and related, you know, legal and work and licensing review that's happening? I think it's probably underappreciated the impact that has on the ability to communities to form and co-create.
Yeah, sure. So right now what I'm doing is significant work related to product clearance and open source diligence for all the products at Cloudera, but that also includes export review as well. So I'm in a little bit of a unique position in that I'm not a lawyer. I'm also not a software engineer, but through all the experience that I gained at IBM, and working with, you know, hundreds, if not thousands, of software engineers, I've got a pretty decent technical background at this point. So in my role, I have used several different tools for code scanning, including in-house tools and very well-known commercial tools as well. And so I've seen and have formed opinions about each of those tools. And then also consuming open source from large projects like the Apache Software Foundation, what those notice files look like, what some of the challenges are related to third-party code, and what information is provided by that particular package or project. And so from my perspective, I think it would be fantastic to take a really close look at potentially having some sort of standards related to notice files, considering how many tools are available on the market.
Great. And Traven, your background is also something that's, you know, not traditionally seen as part of the open source community: marketing, communications, community management, and development. Again, how does that fit into your current open source activities, and what do you see its role in helping open source software develop and continue to gain success?
Yeah, well, when I really got started in the open source space and spent a lot of time on it, I contributed a lot of the expertise I had to a lot of the projects that were around. Hyperledger is one of them, where I contributed to the white paper titled Introduction to Hyperledger. I was part of the marketing committee at the time, And actually, most of the people who were contributing to the white paper were from the technical steering committee. So me being there kind of helped things out in terms from a communication standpoint, making sure that it's very understandable from a non-developer perspective. I mean, of course, a lot of the people who are also contributing also kept that in mind, but I'd like to think that my expertise kind of helped that move along more easily. And yeah, it was a way for me to kind of say, like, I'll contribute this expertise. Please give me back some knowledge with regards to the technical side of things and how things work. And it worked quite well for me. I now do also, you know, technical solutions consulting in addition to things with marketing and business strategy. So yeah, I continue every day to, you know, look for ideas and things around the open source space that could probably use my help. Some of them are completely voluntary, and some of them are done in a professional manner. Voluntary, of course, here with OSI. And I think there's quite a lot of space for other marketers and anybody else in communication to try to find an area to work in the open source space, because it's very much needed, especially around documentation, not just for developers, but also perhaps users and enterprises that might be interested in using open source software.
Yeah. You know, the two of you, I think, are perfect for OSIdeas. There are so many, and they're great webcasts and blogcasts, podcasts and blogs and so on around the technical aspects of open source, the engineering side. And I think what will be unique here is the two unique perspectives that you two will bring to the OSIdeas webcast. Podcast. I don't even know what this officially is at this point. But as it emerges, I hope those discussions that aren't happening on those other channels can happen here. What are some of the things that you're most interested in for OSIdeas, whether it's the format or the possible guests, the topics? What are the things that are most interesting to you and that you hope that we can cover on OSIdeas? Casey?
Yeah, I know I sound like a broken record, but that's because of what I do on a day-to-day basis. So really notice files. But, you know, also there some of the challenges, at least from my personal experience, is a license is a license is a license. And many lawyers will differ in opinions on what the requirements are. And so from a topics perspective, what I would love to look at with OSIdeas is it are not only notice files and creating potentially standards around that or best practices, but also license compatibility. There's so many different places on the internet with opinions, and every company can look at those differently. I think it would benefit the open source community and companies at large in an enormous way. To take a closer look at those.
Great. Traven?
I'm looking forward to having discussions around community management, around the open source space. It's definitely quite different from doing community management for any proprietary software or really anything that's like kind of being sold, because you have people who are not only enjoying the product, but you're also having people who are contributing to the product and helping things grow and decide in direction of where it could go. Of course, it's not true for all open source projects, but that's true for many. And so having those discussions will definitely be quite interesting. I've been to some conferences around open source where we've had some sections around community management and discussions, and as well as all of the business stuff around it and admin things, you know, running a foundation or having an association. And I think, yeah, having that discussion out there would be quite interesting, since it's not something that's, you know, as attractive as all of the other ones, mostly around the technical development side. But then also I'm very excited to have some sections that are, you know, relevant for people who are very new to the open source space and who are non-developers. I mean, there was this one video game that I used to play and still play every now and then called Team Fortress 2. And there was some big fear because there was like a source code leakage. And they were like, oh, no, everything's going to be stolen. It's all going to be broken. And it's just a big misconception of what open source is. And so I'm hoping that this would also be able to address that. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, I agree. The non-developer guest would be fantastic. You know, one of the goals here is to send out an invitation to the open source community and the other members of the Advocate Circle and the OSI board as well to invite speakers, guests to join us. So I want to thank you both for taking on yet another volunteer role in support of open source. The Open Source Initiative and the board is very excited about this, and thank you very much for your time and your contributions here. We will be sending out a bit more information in upcoming to for those who are interested in joining us, and the ideas that you might have, the interests you might have to share on the OS Ideas. We have to think of a name, podcast, webcast, I don't know what this is. But again, thank you both not only for your time doing this, but all the work you're doing to help promote open source software across, well, everywhere. Thanks so much.
Thanks as well, Pastor.
Thanks.